This video is the first of a multi-part series where we'll turn this into this. And we'll do this ourselves using Cheat Engine by making a fully functional cheat table we can use again and again. And the best part is, once you learn the fundamentals, you can do this in almost any single-player PC game. Welcome to Game Hacking 201. In this video, we'll take our first look at manipulating game instructions in Cheat Engine. But this series is geared to those who have a basic understanding of Cheat Engine already. So if you're brand new, I'll throw up a link on the screen and in the description below to the Game Hacking 100 series, which covers the basics. And if you at least go through the videos on your screen, you'll be in a great spot to kick off the 200 series with this video, which is kinda waiting for us, so let's get to it. Alright, I've got Cheat Engine loaded, and I'll fire up Nioh, and yes, if you're coming from the 100 series, I know, same game. But bear with me. It's got an anti-cheat that's pretty easy to get around, which we'll run into in a few minutes, and it has all sorts of different value types and instruction types that range from super easy to a bit more complicated. So, let's get started with the XP value, which in this game is called Amrita, whatever, it's XP. And it's very easy to find. Just do 2 or 3 exact value 4-byte scans as we did in the 100 series, and you're all set. And the bottom address will be the one that affects XP. Now for the anti-cheat I mentioned. I'll slow the game down with the speed hack and change the value to, say, 10,000. And this will happen fast, so keep a close eye on XP. Did you see it? It changed to 10,000 right before the anti-cheat shut us down. So I'll speed through getting the game fired back up and let's continue. Notice that the XP address didn't lose the value. Cheat Engine has the address colored in green for us, which indicates it's a base or static address, which means it doesn't really change between game loads. Anyway, back to the anti-cheat. It's triggered when we change some of the game values directly, such as XP, but for whatever reason it doesn't seem to care if we modify any of the game codes. So I'm gonna head to this shrine and over to the level up screen because I want to find out what instruction is updating the XP value when I level up. Okay, now I'll right-click the row of the XP address and click Find Out What Writes to This Address. This little window pops up asking us to confirm attaching the debugger to the game. Before you click Yes, head to Edit, Settings, then Debugger Options and make sure that your debugger is set to use VEH Debugger. So click OK, and again, right-click on the address and choose Find Out What Writes to This Address, and then go ahead and click Yes. And I'll drag this new window over here, that looks good, and right now there's nothing here because I haven't leveled up yet, which actually causes the XP value to update. So I'll go ahead and level up the body stat and watch what happens in the window. There we go, something's been loaded in. And all this mess on the right side is our instruction. And the number to the left under the count column is the number of times this instruction has run since Cheat Engine has been tracking it. Now, the instructions run only once, but if I level up again, the count will increase. And if I keep leveling up, the count will keep increasing too, as long as the debugger is active. But since we have what we need here, I'll click Stop to the bottom right of this window, which will disable the debugger. Alright, we have the instruction, now what do we do with it? Well, it appears that the instruction only runs when I level up, and since we know this instruction is the one updating our value, let's see what happens if I just disable it. Two ways to do this. You can click this Replace button and then click OK in this window, or you can right-click the row and click Replace with code that does nothing and click OK in this window again. Okay, let's test this. And look at that, it looks like I still have 6638 XP. Let's test it a few more times, and it looks like I could just keep at this until the XP needed for the next level surpasses how much XP I currently have. But there's a slight problem. The instruction changes in RAM, which if you recall from the 100 series, means that when we shut off the game and reload it, everything gets set back to the way it was before we changed it. So what we'll want to do is create a script that will find the instruction and disable it and add the script to our cheat table so we can then save it and use it whenever we want. And this is actually a lot faster than scanning for pointers most of the time. And because I closed the window where the original instruction was loaded, I'll again need to right-click the address, then click Find Out What Writes to This Address, and then go level up again. And I actually got lucky here because this game is using a static address for XP that doesn't change. In most other games, I would have needed to rescan for the address again, which can be really tedious and annoying depending on how difficult it was to find to begin with. So a good habit is to save the instruction to the code list so you can retrieve it when you need it. Just highlight it and click Add to the Code List. And in this window that pops up, you can give your instruction a name by typing to the left of this colon. Just don't change anything to the right or you'll screw with the code itself. And then click OK. And now the instruction is in the code list, which you can bring up when you click Advanced Options at the bottom of Cheat Engine. And now just save the cheat table and you'll always have access to the instruction even if the game or Cheat Engine crashes for whatever reason. Alright, let's do this. With the instruction highlighted, click Show Disassembler, which will bring up the Memory Viewer, which we took a look at in the 100 series. But this time ignore the bottom half, we're only interested in what's up here. Specifically, just make sure that the instruction we used as a hook to bring us here in the first place is highlighted, and click Tools, then Auto Assemble, which brings up this new window. Here is where we'll create our script, and Cheat Engine makes this really easy because it has templates that create most of the code for us, which we can get to by heading up here and clicking Template. And we have several options here to choose from, but we'll do a simple code injection for this script, and once I click it, Cheat Engine preloads all the required code to get us started. One thing to note is that we want to add this script to our cheat table so we can use it again. The execute button here will run our code only once, and if we close this window, we'll lose the script and need to start all over again. Instead, click File and assign a current cheat table. But this isn't going to work right now because we don't have the framework we need in the script for it to work in a cheat table. This is easily added by clicking Templates again, then choosing Cheat Table Framework Code. But if you choose this after you choose Code Injection, Cheat Engine doesn't generate the code needed under the Disable section. So I'll close the script, then click Tools and then Auto Symbol again. And this time I'll click Cheat Table Framework Code first, and then Code Injection, which loads everything we need where we need it to have a fully functional script. And now I can click File, then Add a Current Cheat Table with no issues. And I'll close this copy of the script, and I'll close the Memory Viewer, and I'll get this out of our way too. Alright, here's our script. Let's bring up the script view by double-clicking the script text under the value column. And I won't go into the finer details right now, but for a brief introduction, everything between the enable command and the disable command is what will happen when we activate our script, which we can do by clicking inside the square here, which places the familiar red X inside it. And everything below the disable command is what will happen when we deactivate our script, which we can also do by clicking inside the square again. So ignore pretty much everything else in the script, but let's take a closer look at the stuff right under original code. The first instruction is the one we're interested in. It's the one that updates our XP, and by pulling up the code list, you can see that it matches the instruction I saved earlier. And for right now, don't worry about what these letters, numbers, and brackets all mean. We'll get to all that later. For now, I'm just going to get rid of the instruction by highlighting it and then pressing backspace to delete it. That's it! And I'll click OK at the bottom, which will save that change, and now let's test our script. I'll click inside the square again to activate it, and go level up. And it looks like it's working to me. My XP is not decreasing as I level up. So I'll deactivate the script, and XP should start decreasing normally again. And it does. But now XP is too low to keep leveling, and even if I reactivate the script, that wouldn't really help me right now. I'd need to go back and grind for XP. And sure, if I was careful and only leveled up when my script was active, I'd never lose any XP gained, which definitely would save a ton of time compared to what I'd normally have to do. But come on now, we're game hackers. We can do better. But we'll actually need to understand the game's code and manipulate things to do what we want them to if we want to make more impressive changes. Which is exactly what we'll get into in Game Hacking 202, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss it. And I'll throw up a link on the screen and in the description when it's ready. Thanks for watching, see you next time.